Hello, my pupilos, and welcome to a new Spanish lesson with me, Sebas. I know it's been a while since the last time I uploaded a video about pronunciation, but here we are again. So, today, we will learn how to pronounce the letter Y, or letter Y, as we call it in Spanish, which I will have to say, it's a really pretty easy topic, so you can relax for now. Basically, we have two ways to pronounce this letter. The first one, when it's before a vowel, and the second one, when it's on the end of the word. The first way, I would have to say that it's pretty similar to the Y in English. So I guess that you won't have any problem to learn this. At least I guess. Y para matar dos pájaros de un tiro, what? With the confused face. It's an expression we use when we achieve two things with one single action. So it's really similar to the English expression. Yes, to kill two birds with one stone. So in Spanish, we kill them with a gun instead of a stone. How sadistic we are. So, to kill two birds with one stone, we'll also practice the pronunciation of the digraph double L. Do you remember about the digraph? If not, you can watch it on the link up there. So, as you're probably guessing, these digraphs sound exactly the same as the letter Y. And yes, it also sounds similar to the Y in English. So that's why many people make some orthography mistakes when we talk about this sound. Like for example, the typical haya from the verb haber versus haya from the verb hallar. So come on, please let's practice some orthography. But that's something we will see in another video. Now, let's see some examples which you will repeat after me. Yogurt, yeso, yunque. Yogurt, yeso, yunque. Now it's your turn. Very good. Now, let's contrast it with the sound of the double L and you will see that there's no difference. Llama, llanta, lluvia. Llama, llanta, lluvia. Now it's your turn. I can hear you. Very good. Now, let's talk about the other sound of the letter Y when it's at the end of a word. And I will have to say that it's the same sound of the vowel I, which also would be something similar to English. Oh my God, this will be your lucky day. Like one of the most common words we use in the everyday. Yo soy or yo estoy. You would never say yo soy or yo estoy, would you? So let's see more examples so you never ever forget. Rey, buey, pejerrey. Rey, buey, pejerrey. Now it's your turn. Very good. Y bueno, mis queridos pupilos, eso es todo por hoy. If you have any question, opinion, or recommendation, please go ahead and put your comments below. And if you like this video, thumb up and subscribe. Soy Sebas y hasta la próxima.